speakers. We're going to have a few questions. Sue Chan and I are going to serve as respondents, and we're going to try to do it fairly quickly because we're running a little bit behind schedule. Then what we're going to do for the very first time we've ever done this is a short debate. The debate question is going to be, can designers save the world, or must they save their profession first? We're not going to follow any of the usual parliamentary rules of debate. It's going to be fairly loose. We're going to try to move it along quickly, but I think it's a way of wrapping up the theme, which is design, save, .. And of course, what's more important than saving the world or maybe saving our profession? Anyway, so Jeff, you want to come up here with me?
Oh, okay. Okay, just get right to it. I mean, we listen to all these different professions, right? From designers to architects. But at the end of the day, what are we doing with this form is what is the thread that weaves these things together? Because we hear about processes, depending on your concerns, but ultimately, all the speakers will reference one way or the other to their work, right? So at the end of the day, what we're going to get out of this, what is the threat, put it out there, that the audience can see? Because we attend a lot of these forums, we would like to hear what's the commonality between these speakers.
I think, you know, the critical question is, what are we saying, which means, what are the things we really value? I mean, even if we can save the world, what is it in the world that we want to save? And I think the diversity of the topics, like Ambassador Chan talking about social capital, you know, basically people. It's, you know, the buildings aren't important, it's the way people interact with the buildings. Designing to save our sanity, I mean, ultimately it comes down to each one of us. Who are we? Each person's brain works in a very different way. So of course there is no sane way of doing it. We're all crazy in our own particular way, and we're all sane in our own special way. So I think, you know, the discussion raises many issues. I mean, I like the Ambassador Chan's question to Will about why aren't there more people in the forecast? I think that says as much about architectural photography as it does about architecture. But I know Will's work, and I've seen the Central Library, and every single time I've been in there, it's been packed. And I think that's usually the way you can judge, you know, how effective architecture is. It's how many people does it draw, and how do the people interact with it?
I just want to add that all these questions are I'm more of the opinion that architects should save the profession, just to get it going in that direction, because we are all tied to our own little processes. The way we educate in school is about process. But what really matters is really time, history, and place. And really, I'm also sure today's education is geared towards understanding of culture and history. Mm-hmm. It's not as broad-based. So we all start out in school struggling with the processes. And then we leave quite idealistic. The way I like to put it out is I think the profession is safe.
I think, you know, the space that we're sitting in right now talks to what you just said.
Because it took me a while to realize that once you master the process of the education that the language of architecture, you really need to go back and visit and see the world and then understand the materials, understand the process and history. A lot of what we're talking about can settle itself given time. Time is the other one, and I don't think we can force it. But in terms of just reacting to space, is an intuition that comes with time. So I think time is a very big element. And the way the profession advocates is we start again from the very basic. So it's very important to learn from others and to learn history, because the issues of dwelling and living is not changing thousands of years.
So having a broad-based education and understanding sociology and political history is very, very important, and this is quite lacking. And also just understanding the structure and the formal grammar of different types of architecture, such as classical architecture, is important. Because we don't have time to discover ourselves. We need to learn by rote some of the bare facts. We need to learn and learn from other people. But so much of what I see at the school today is the architect as a hero, understanding process, and then projecting it, and go out and save the world. I don't think that's possible.
I mean, it's interesting, the concept of time. Part of it, of course, is history, but also we live in a particular time. It means the moment that we're in. But it was also interesting with Linda and Talia Small, their idea of occupying the momentary. And Juan asked an interesting question about, would you want to make it permanent? And in some ways, I think it loses something. If it those installations were created to be there just temporarily. And part of their impact, I think, was the notion that they will only be there a short period of time. I mean, in Japan, when you go there in the springtime, they love the cherry blossoms, in part because they know the cherry blossoms only bloom for a week and a half every year. If the cherry blossoms were in bloom 12 months out of the year, they would not be nearly as after 9/11 in New York, there were these, this installation was done, Towers of Light. And it basically was this abstraction of the towers in these two beams of light. And one of the reasons why it happened was it was sold as it was just temporary. The city would never have approved something very quickly if they knew it was going to be permanent. So one value of temporary is you can get it done quickly. And after they did it, everybody loved it, there was a push to make it permanent, or at least permanent until there was a replacement, a real replacement to the World Trade Centers. And the artists were very smart. They said no. They said people died here, they lived, and then they were extinguished. These towers of light will be here for 1 week, and then they will be extinguished. They eventually were convinced to do it once a year, at 9/11 for a couple of days. But each time, the light gets extinguished. It's only there for a limited period. And I think that's very much why they are powerful. Anyway, do you want to make one more comment? And then maybe we'll go to the debate?
Very short. I think the different speakers have different concerns, so it's just a industry concern. Whether it's craft or brick or graphic design. But the concern for looking for a sense of place has been around, and I think the other question is really how all these concerns can be focused in this forum.
And what is a place, I think, is changing. I mean, traditionally a place is right here, but is the internet a place? Anyway, that's a question. We're going to bring all of the speakers. We're going to get rid of the big chairs, we're going to put some really small chairs up here, we're going to get everybody up, and then we're going to debate for maybe just 10 minutes on the topic of, can designers save the world, or must they save their profession first? And then when we're finished, we're going to have a vote. People are going to raise their hands, and which side, you're going to say which side won. We'll do this very informally.